Hello friends, in this video we are going to talk about the antioxidant assay by the phosphomolybdenum method. So in last videos I'll give the link in the description. We have estimated how to analyze the antioxidant properties of a plant extract by the DPPH method. So there are so many methods to analyze the antioxidant activities. We have to follow more than one or two methods to get an overall antioxidant properties. We just can't stop with the DPPH activity. We have to analyze with another two or three more methods. So this is a second method to analyze the antioxidant properties of your plant extracts using the phosphomolybdenum reagent. Hence, it is called as phosphomolybdate method. So now, what is antioxidant? So if you watch the other video, antioxidant activity by DPPH method, there I would have given a clear picture how antioxidants are formed, what are free radical, what is free radical scavenging activity, all those things I would have given. I have explained it very detailed. So here, I will just quickly brief through it. So antioxidants are nothing but there are certain free radicals that are produced in a plant, in the human body or in any living organisms. There are free radicals produced. These free radicals are toxic. They are like chain reactions. They go and hit another molecule and they cause free radicals. So 1 becomes 2, 2 becomes 4. So like this, it causes continuous free radicals. So due to this continuous production of free radicals, it leads to cell toxicity. And it also leads to many diseases like rheumatoid arthritis, liver damage, inflammation, and also even to cancer. So to prevent the activity of these free radicals, to prevent the damage caused by these free radicals, there are certain molecules called as antioxidants. So these antioxidants are naturally produced in plants. For example, if you take green tea, they say green tea is rich in antioxidants. They have high antioxidant activity. That is why green tea is good for health. It reduces belly fat and all those things. It makes you active. That is the reason they say to consume green tea. Similarly, all the plant system produces antioxidants, but it produces in various concentrations. Some antioxidant will be very less in some plants. Some antioxidants will be produced in higher quantity in other plants. So this experiment helps us to analyze how much antioxidants are produced in a plant system in percentage wise. What is the antioxidant activity of the plant? So that is the main criteria or the principle of this aim of this experiment. What is the percentage of antioxidant that is produced in my plant system that we are going to analyze? There are many methods, like one method DPPH. I've already made a video and I've showed you over there. And this is the second method, phosphomolybdenum method. We are going to use phosphomolybdenum reagent. So now before going on to the protocol, let me say you what and all are the chemicals that is required for this experiment. First, the main reagent is the plant extract. So you need plant extracts. Either you can do methanol reagent or you can use chloroform or ethanol. So based on the availability of your solvents, you can prepare the plant extracts. I have 20 plant extracts. So I have made another video how to prepare plant extracts using different solvent. For those people who haven't watched those videos, I will give the link in the description. Please do go and watch those videos. So this is the first and most important thing. We are going to analyze how much antioxidant activity is there in my plant extract. So the requirements are the plant extract. Next, you need to prepare phosphomolybdenum reagent. So to prepare this phosphomolybdenum reagent, you need three chemicals. So first is your sodium phosphate. So it can be dibasic or monobasic depending on what is your availability in your lab. You need sodium phosphate. So molecular weight will be given. So sodium phosphate, we need 28 millimolar of sodium phosphate. So this I have taken dibasic. So based on this, you can calculate. We need 28 millimolar sodium phosphate. So just make a note out of it whenever I'm saying you, because I'm not showing you the protocol or the chemicals. I'm just saying you orally. So it will be difficult for you to remember. Just take a pen and paper and note it down. We need sodium phosphate, 28 millimolar. You can make it 100 ml or 500 ml, 1000 ml depending upon the samples that you are having. So I will say you how to prepare, what to add. So first is sodium phosphate, 28 millimolar. Next, we require ammonium molybdate. Ammonium molybdate, we require 4 millimolar. So I hope you all know how to calculate it. We need 4 millimolar ammonium molybdate. So this is your tetrahydrate. That means they have 6 hydrogen water molecules are there. So depending upon the number of hydrate molecules, the molecular weight will differ. Tetra means 4. So it has 4 hydrogen water molecules. So molecular weight depends according based on the number of water molecules. So ammonium molybdate, so what reagent you're having, based on the CD molecular weight mentioned, and calculate 4 millimolar ammonium molybdate. Next, we need sulfuric acid. We require 0.6 molar sulfuric acid. So this is commercially available H2SO4 sulfuric acid. You have to calculate the strength of sulfuric acid first. So whenever we are having solvents or acids like this, if we are not going to take only the molecular weight, we have a different process. We have to calculate the strength of this H2SO4. This is somewhere around 18.35 somewhere. Yeah. So I had calculated, I got 18.35 molar is the strength of my commercially available sulfuric acid. So from this, using the formula C1V1 equals C2V2, I will calculate 0.6 molar. So if you require 100 ml or 500 ml, depending upon your extracts, you can prepare how much ever you want volume. So 0.6 molar. So I will just repeat these three components: 28 millimolar sodium phosphate, 4 millimolar ammonium molybdate, 0.6 molar sulfuric acid. These three reagents, I'm going to prepare it individually. So I have prepared over here So this is 28 millimolar sodium phosphate. I've just taken 100 ml for all. I'm sorry, 50 ml I've taken. So we have to add in equal amount. So if you're preparing 100 ml of sodium phosphate, you need to prepare 100 ml of ammonium molybdate and also 100 ml of sulfuric acid. So it has to be in equal volume. Or if you do not require that much of volume, you just require some 20 or 30 ml, just prepare 10 ml sodium phosphate, 10 ml ammonium molybdate and 10 ml sulfuric acid. Then if you add all these three in equal components in equal proportion, you will get phosphomolybdenum reagent 30 ml. So that is required. That is enough. So now I have taken 50 ml of 28 molar sodium phosphate, 50 ml of 4 millimolar ammonium molybdate and 50 ml of 0.6 molar sulfuric acid. Now all these three I am going to add together and prepare freshly and individual components. So maximum try to use it within today or tomorrow. So don't prepare it freshly. So this is 28 molar sodium phosphate I have prepared. So first component of the reagent. Next is 4 millimolar ammonium molybdate. 4 millimolar ammonium molybdate. Dissolve it individually, then mix it. Okay. And next, finally, 0.6 molar sulfuric acid. So 0.6 molar sulfuric acid. So this gives me now the phosphomolybdenum reagent. So label it, put date properly and store it in cold room in dark place, clean dark place. So this is my phosphomolybdenum reagent is ready now. So 150 ml is there now. Phosphomolybdenum reagent. So that is my very important. Only three reagents are required to make this phosphomolybdenum reagent. It is very simple. This entire assay is very easy. So if you see my other videos of proline estimation, protein estimation, carbohydrate estimation, you have a laborious chemicals, laborious process you have. But when compared to all those things, this is very simple. You just require phosphomolybdenum reagent and your plant extracts. That's all. You can finish this within 2 hours, the entire assay. Now let me give you the principle. So what is the actual principle is when this plant extract is added to the phosphomolybdenum reagent, the antioxidants that are present in the plant extracts, my plant sample, they reduce the phosphomolybdenum. They reduce the phosphomolybdenum and they will give a different color. And this will be done in 90-95 degrees Celsius and it will be kept for 1.5 hours. So we are going to take water bath, so similar to phenol sulfuric acid. So preheat the water bath, add enough amount of water and make sure the temperature is 95 degrees Celsius. And you're going to leave it for 1.5 hours or 90 minutes. And then you're going to take the absorbance. So the antioxidants react with the phosphomolybdenum that is present in my phosphomolybdenum reagent. They reduce it and it gives me a certain color. And that color is, I'm going to take the absorbance value and we're going to plot the standard graph. So similar to all the other experiments, biochemical experiments, we are going to plot the standard graph. You can use ascorbic acid, you can use tocopherols. So whichever is available in your lab, using that, we will plot the standard graph and we will get Y is equals to mx square reaction. So using that reaction, we'll get to know the value of the unknown sample. So that is so simple as that. So now, let me say you the protocol, then I will show you. So you're going to take 0.1 ml of plant extracts. So you're going to take 0.1 ml of plant extract. So that is nothing but 100 microliter. So you need micropipette and you need tips, everything you require for this. And I'm going to do it in append of tubes. So if you're doing it in test tubes, similarly, you can increase your concentration. You can make it 1 ml and you can simultaneously increase the phosphomolybdenum reagent also according to your whichever method you're following. So since I'm doing it in append of tubes and using microplate reader, I don't have to do it in high volume. So I have taken 0.1 ml, that is 100 microliter of my plant extract, and I will take 1 ml of phosphomolybdenum reagent. That is nothing but 1000 microliters of phosphomolybdenum reagent. And I'm going to shake it well, mix it well, and then I'm going to incubate it at 90 degrees Celsius for 90 or 95 degrees Celsius for 1.5 hours. I'm going to incubate and then I'm going to take the absorbance. Then I'm going to cool it at room temperature. So as soon as 1.5 hours is over, just don't take that hot extraction, take the absorbance. You will get wrong values. Cool it to room temperature and you will take the absorbance at 695 nanometer. Yes. So you will take the absorbance at 695 nanometer. So this is so simple, this protocol is, and we need blank. So blank will be methanol. So whatever solvent I have used, if you have used ethanol, you can use ethanol as a blank, or I used methanol. So I'm going to use 100 microliter of methanol plus 1 ml of phosphomolybdenum reagent. That is my blank. And I'm going to plot the standard graph. So in many videos I have discussed how to do standard graph of various concentration. So if you don't know how to prepare standard graphs and all, you can watch my other videos to get to know how to prepare standard graph. Now it is ready. We will start without any delay. So I have 20 samples and I'm going to do it in triplicates. Always whatever biochemical assays you're doing it, you have to do it in triplicates. That is to minimize the error. So this is the stand for this append of tubes so that I can keep it in water bath like this for 1.5 hours. So this is the stand for append of tubes and this is my 2 ml append of tubes I have taken. So 1 ml, 1.5 ml, 2 ml, many sizes comes. I have taken 2 ml append of tubes and I have labeled all this. So I have 60 samples I have. Since I have 20 plant extracts, in triplicates I'm going to do 60 samples I will get. So I have labeled everything. Now what I'm going to do is I'll just show you one extract and then it remains same for everything. So I've taken the root extract, 100 microliter I'm going to take, yes. So label it properly when you're having many samples. 100 microliter in triplicates, 100. Hundred, 100 microliter of plant extract. Now to this plant extract, I'm going to add 1 ml or 1000 microliters of the phosphomolybdenum reagent that I prepared. Phosphomolybdenum reagent, we are going to add 1000 microliters or 1 ml, and then we are going to shake it well. You can use Vortex or CycloMixer, and you can give a nice mix, and you can incubate it. Then you will incubate it at 95 degrees Celsius for 90 minutes. That is nothing but 1.5 hour. So that is all the procedure. It is so simple. So I will prepare out all the extracts, and I will add the reagent, and then I will show you how to proceed with. So friends, now I've added 1 ml of phosphomolybdenum reagent, and I've added 0.1 ml of that is 100 microliter of plant reagent, and I'm giving a quick spin using the CycloMixer. So similarly, I've given a quick spin for all the 60 extracts that I am having. So before incubation, if you just see the difference, this is of my root sample. The root sample is light, white, and transparent. While if you see my leaf sample, it is becoming bluish in color, greenish to bluish color. It is becoming, it is transforming. While stem is remaining light green color, but seed samples are still whitish in color. So this is before incubation. So I've added all the reagent extracts, given a quick spin. Now my water bath is ready. It is boiling at 95 degrees in temperature, and now I'm going to keep this entire apparatus in my boiling water bath for 1.5 hour, and then I will show you what is the reaction that has occurred and what color did we see. Extract and the phosphomolybdenum reagent I've added, and I'm keeping it in water bath for incubation at 95 degrees Celsius for 90 minutes. I'm going to keep. So it is ready over here. Yes. So we will leave it for incubation for 1.5 hour or 90 minutes, and then we will take the absorbance. Then we will see the color changes. So friends, after 1.5 hour incubation in hot water, 90 to 95 degrees Celsius, I have cooled it to room temperature, and I have given a quick spin using this Vortex. Now, just for your observation, I can show you. This is the root sample. You can see beautiful blue color has been developed, and this is the stem sample. When you compare this root sample and stem sample is lighter, the root sample is darker. That indicates that roots are having more antioxidant molecules. That is why the most of the phosphomolybdenum has been reduced, and it has given more bluish color compound. And this is my leaf extract. Leaf and root are almost same, and this is my seed extract. Seeds are having even more darker color, so it's a medicinal plant, and seeds are mainly consumed for medicinal properties. So this indicates that just by my physical observation, so just from my physical observation, I am coming to a conclusion that seeds are having more antioxidant properties, then roots are having showing more, then leaf, and then is the last is the stem. So, but still we have to plot the graph, and we have to take the absorbance reading, and all those things we have to do. So this is just the result. You can see a beautiful blue color will be developed, greenish blue color, I can say it. And I have to give you some tips over here, 2 to 3 tips I have here. So whenever you're keeping this append of tubes in the water bath, if it is 60 or 70 degrees Celsius, and you're closing it with the lid, because of the excess of pressure, what happens? The append of tube gets opened like this, and all the water gets evaporated, and the entire thing gets dried up. So always be very careful whenever you're keeping append of tubes, especially in case of in water bath. Come and check every 10 minutes, 15 minutes, whether the append of tubes are getting opened. So without your observation, the append of tube just gets opened like this, and all the water gets evaporated. So you have to make sure that the water in the water bath is also in proper limit. So make sure that the level of the water is maintained, and all the append of tubes are closed. Come and check once in a while, 10 minutes or 15 minutes like that. That is the first thing that I wanted to say you. And second thing is, if you take for my eyes, I will just compare it as darker, lighter like that. But whenever you're using your spectrophotometer or a microplate reader, if the absorbance values goes above 2 or 2.5, that indicates that it is too concentrated and you have to dilute it. And don't dilute after all your analysis. When you're going for microplate reading, don't dilute, add methanol. Since I have used methanol to make my solvent, to make my extracts, so I will be diluting using methanol. If you have used ethanol or water to prepare your extracts, use the same solvent. And it has to be done before you add the reagent. So in today's experiment, I had added 100 microliter of extract. That extract had a concentration of 10 microgram, 10 milligram per ml. So unless and until I go and take my absorbance, I will not come to know whether it is concentrated or whether it is diluted. So if my absorbance values are more than 2, then I have to repeat it, and then I have to dilute it. So then instead of taking 100 microliter, I will take 50 microliter, and I will add 450 microliter methanol, and the total volume will be 500 microliter to that 1 ml of phosphomolybdenum reagent I can add. So because my stock is 10 mg per ml, it is too concentrated. If your stock is in micrograms or 1 mg per ml, so you can directly take 10 or 100 microliters, that will not be an issue. So only after taking the absorbance, we will come to know whether my samples are concentrated or diluted. So that one I wanted to say you, that is one tip. And now, as if you've seen my other videos, you would have been knowing that I'll be always using microplate reader. This is called as an ELISA plate or microplate. It has 96 well. Since I have 60 samples, it will be very laborious and very difficult for me to use the normal spectrophotometer, because I have to wash the cuvette and add at a time. Only one sample or four or five samples I can use. Again, I have to wash each time, and it takes 2 to 3 hours it takes for me to analyze 60 samples. But if I am using microplate reader and microplate, many types comes, flat bottom, U bottom. So if you watch my other videos, I would have compared. You would have seen how I will take reading in this video. Just to cut short of time, I'm not going to show you how I'm going to take readings and all. So you can just watch my other videos, any biochemical assays, I would have shown you how to take microplate reading in the end. So within a fraction of seconds, I will get the value of all the 96 wells. So it is very much time consuming, and also it reduces my volume of chemicals and the reagents that I'm using. If I'm taking cuvette, cuvette will be some 2 to 3 ml I have to pour. So I have to do it entire chemicals. I have to increase, instead of taking 1 ml, I have to take 10 ml. So much of chemicals are also getting wasted. So this is more economical, more time consuming, more easier method also. So I will just show you how to pipette it. Then later, microplate readings, you can watch my other videos. So usually this will hold 300 to 350 microliter, but I will not take 300 to 350. I will just take 200. 200 is sufficient to take readings. So cool, after any analysis, cool it down. And then I am going to pipette out 200 microliter. Yes, and I didn't show you the blank. So this is my blank. You can see there has been no reaction occurred if I take my blank and the extract, because blank is not having, we didn't add any plant extract. So blank doesn't have any antioxidant molecules to reduce the phosphomolybdenum and give a bluish colored complex. So that is why a blank is as white color it is. So now I have just taken 200, I have given a thorough mix after all the reagents so that it becomes uniform, and I will just take 200 and pipette, and I will show you. Such beautiful bluish color compound complex has been formed. So 200. Similarly, for all the 60 samples, I will do it. And this costs you also very less. It doesn't take the one entire, I bought it from Vasa Scientific. I think 50 cases comes, that costs only 1800 or something that is. It is very cheap. So if you can actually buy it in bulk, and you can share it with your other colleagues and other juniors. That is what even I did. So I bought some 50 cases and I shared it with my colleagues. I have taken 10 cases. Similarly, 10 sets I have given for everyone. So it becomes cheaper also for me. So yes, so this is how I pipetted all the samples, and I go and keep this in microplate reader, and within a fraction of seconds, I get the readings. So you can watch the other videos how to take the readings of the absorbance. So this is all the protocol that I wanted to share with you today. So this finishes the experiment. So this, then you have to plot standard graph, like I mentioned, using ascorbic acid or using tocopherol, and these are considered as unknown value. So with this and using the standard graph, I will show you that in other videos I've shown you. And there is one more video also, how to plot standard graph. I'll give that link also in description. So you can find out all those things and you can plot the standard graph. And this completes the biochemical assay antioxidant activity by phosphomolybdate method. So I wish it was very clear for you all. If you have any doubts, you can contact me by the mail ID that I have given in my description, or you can leave a comment. And if you like this video, do give a thumbs up, and thanks for your patience watching, and do subscribe to my channel for more such biology related videos. Thank you.